Hello, this is Tom from Never Center. I'm going to show you in this video one of the biggest new features that we've put into Silo 2022.0, which is our newest release, which is the implementation of Pixar's Open Subdiv to power our subdivision surfaces. I'm going to show a few different features in 2022 in different videos. So this video will just focus on what Open Subdiv brings to Silo and why you're going to like it. So I've got the last 2021 version of Silo here on the left. So this is Silo 2021.5. And then on the right, this is Silo 2022.0. So on the right, we have the Open Subdiv version, the new hotness. And on the left, we have the old hotness, which was our own custom subdivision surfaces engine. So to show you the difference, let's just load the same model into both. Let's go with base. Actually, I want to do base man with feet. Custom primitive base man with feet. Okay. It's one of the custom models built into Silo. We'll open this in the other, in the newer version also, base man with feet. So we've got the same model in the new and the old version of Silo. So let's start with the old version, 2021.5. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to subdivide this to about 1 million polys or 2 million tries. And I'll be rotating him as I do so you can see what the delay is between subdivision levels. So you'll see where it freezes a little bit while it's subdividing. So let's do one subdivision, two, three, four. You can see a little pause there, and then I'm about to go up to five, which will take it up to 1 million. We do five. It's thinking. So you see there's like a second or more delay when it did that fifth subdivision level. Now it's up to 1 million isofaces. So now we come over to Silo 2022 with Pixar's Open Subdiv library powering the subdivision. And I'm going to do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you can see it just had way less delay in there. And so it's way faster on high subdivision levels. And not only is it much faster, but if I go into Activity Monitor, you can see this one's sorting it by memory usage. The old Silo 2021.5 is using 1.24 gigabytes of RAM, and Silo 2022, the new one, is using less than half a gigabyte of RAM, 483 megabytes. So it's much better, much more efficient memory usage, and much faster. And just to show that again, so like if you're working on a high subdivision model, say I like delete this. Let me, I need to zoom in here. Select this edge loop, then I'll delete this and we'll see how fast that goes. I hit delete now. It was almost instant. Whereas in the old Silo, I select an edge loop and then I hit delete now. There's a delay, and does that. So you can see much faster. And also things like undoing, I just hit undo and it's thinking, undoes. In the newer Silo, I hit undo and it's almost instant. So one of the things that this will actually be really useful for you is if you're using creasing in your variable edge creasing in your models. So let's take a cube here. And in 2021.5, I'll subdivide this. Let's take it to like about 100,000 polygons, isofaces. And then I'm going to select these edges and crease them. So we've got a hard crease there. And then let's do variable creasing. So if I do crease amount, so I'm just going to drag this down and up. And you can see like as I'm dragging it, because it's quite a high subdivision level, it's kind of laggy between each of those creases, crease levels, not super smooth. Oh, sorry, the reason this keeps going away is because if I have Alt held down when I switch windows, then it hides the other window. Okay, so now let's go to new, better silo 2022. I'm going to subdivide this 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, now we're at 100,000 ISO faces in both. And then Shift S to convert to edges. Edge crease amount. Let's start this at 10. And now when I drag in here, you can see it's much smoother. So this is lets you do much more interactive edge creasing. And coming back to this one just to compare. Slow. New hotness. Fast. So anyway, that's, like I said, one of the banner features of Silo 22.0. And part of what we're seeing here is the Open Subdiv library, but we've also actually done a lot of memory optimization in general. So when you see it here using like half as much RAM, a lot of that is the Open Subdiv, but a lot of that is just improved memory usage from what we made in just updating the core memory management of Silo. So anyway, we'll show you more and more videos, but hopefully that gives you a taste, and we'd love for you to give Silo 2022.0 a download and try it out and let us know what you think. Thanks.